Explanation. Federalism. The system of running the administration of a country cooperatively by the governments at the two levels, making the laws about the different subjects, is called federalism. The federal system is an important feature of our constitution. In countries with large territories and huge populations, government is run by a federal system. The governments function at two levels in a federation. The government at the center carries out tasks like defense of the entire country, foreign policy, establishing peace, etc. It is also called union government or federal government. It carries out the administration of the entire country. The government that oversees the administration of the region that we live in is called state government. It looks after the administration of a particular state, for example, government of Maharashtra. Separation of powers. The constitution has divided the subjects for making laws between the union government and the state governments. Our constitution has given three lists of various subjects. The first list is called Union List. It contains 97 subjects on which the Union government makes laws. The State List has 66 subjects on which state governments to legislate upon. Apart from these two lists, there is a concurrent list which contains 47 subjects. Both governments can make laws on subjects included in this list. If a subject comes up that is not included in any of the lists, the union government is entitled to make laws on it. These powers are termed as residuary powers. Who deals with what subjects? 1. Subjects with the union government. Defense, foreign relations, war and peace, currency, international trade, etc. 2. Subjects with the state government. Agriculture, law and order, local government, health, prison administration, etc. 3. Subjects with both the governments. Employment, environment, economic and social planning, personal law, education, etc. Union Territories. In India, there is a union government, 29 state governments and 7 union territories. The union government controls the union territories. Following are the 7 union territories: New Delhi, Daman and Diu, Pondicherry, Chandigarh, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Lakshadweep. Parliamentary system of government. System is such a system in that the legislature has the highest decision-making power. Indian Parliament includes the President, Lok Sabha or the House of People and Rajya Sabha or the Council of States. In parliamentary democracy, the discussion and debates that take place in the parliament have great significance. Independent judiciary. The Indian constitution has created an independent judiciary. The disputes that cannot be resolved mutually are referred to the judiciary. The court hears both the contesting parties, looks into the injustice, if any, and gives its judgment. This has to be done impartially. The constitution has made several provisions to ensure that the judiciary remains more and more independent. For example, judges are appointed by the president and not by the government. It is not easy to remove the judges from their office. Single citizenship. The Indian constitution has granted a single citizenship to all Indians, that is, Indian citizenship. Process of amending the constitution. there comes up a need to make changes or amendments in the provisions of the Constitution due to changing circumstances. But frequent amendments to the Constitution may lead to a situation of instability. The procedure for amendment is specified in the Constitution itself so as to ensure that an amendment is made only after giving it a careful consideration. Election Commission. Since India has adopted a democratic form of government, people have to elect their representatives periodically. For this, the elections have to be conducted in a free and fair atmosphere. The Constitution has entrusted the responsibility of conducting elections to independent machinery. This machinery is known as Election Commission. The responsibility of conducting all elections in India rests with the Election Commission.